Oh!
What took you so long?
No way!
I smell something fishy.
Are you okay?
Actually,
yeah, that's right.
What's going on?
I see. Well, Hero.
Attention! Listen. I know what to do. Isn't this fun?
Oh my god!
Oh dear.
What?
How did that happen?
Sure thing.
Aiden.
Eh?
Just tell me if you need anything.
Yoshi?
I don't know if I really can.
Stop it! I have an idea.
I see. Attention! Get moving!
All right.
Cheer up.
Come on.
Actually,
hey, cheer up!
Huh?
Yeah, you're right.
Hold on.
I have an idea.
Yeah!
Once upon a time, there was a young boy named Toshu. Toshu was a young and carefree boy. He liked to play outside and play video games. Then one day, one dreadful day.
Oh no.
He went back home and his mother called his name. Toshu. Toshu. Chills ran down to his spine as he saw his mother holding a... Failed report card!
What?
Oh my god, Natsumi, that was so lame!
Hey, nothing is scarier than failing a test which eventually leads you to an unemployed future. Just thinking about it gives me the chills.
I am disappointed in myself for even letting you speak.
Did you like it, Keitaro?
It was okay, I guess.
Oh, my turn! I know this creepy story that will surely knock all your socks off.
You better not tell us another story about a failed report card.
I swear, this one's good. So, it goes like this. One quiet night, in a camp just like this, two best friends, Ichiru and Masaru, went out past their bedtime to check out an abandoned cabin down by the lake. It was rumored that many of the campers who once stayed there vanished mysteriously. The two reached the front door, only to find out it was locked. Masaru suggested that it was a bad idea and insisted that they should just go back. But then, Ichiru found a cellar door in the backyard. Ichiru was so curious that he dragged Masaru down to that basement. It was cold and dark inside, and all they had was a dim flashlight to light up their path. As they slowly walked further, they suddenly heard a creaking sound. Ichiru pointed his flashlight towards the source of the sound, revealing a slightly open door just a few steps away from them. Masaru was shaking in fear as he begged Ichiru to turn back. Ichiru was still up for it, so he pushed that door completely open. Both of their skin turned pale, and their bodies became numb because of fear. Ichiru dropped his flashlight when he saw. The headless campers who were murdered by the scoutmaster!
Ah! I'm not scared.
Yoichi.
What?
Don't worry.
So...
Hero?
Oh no.
What?
Oh no. Maybe.
Yeah, sure.
Yoichi.
I'm not scared.
I've read about this before. I'm sure of it. What should we do?
Hey, stop it!
What?
What?
I...
Hero?
No, I'm not!
Can you stop that?
Mr. Perfect!
Hey!
Don't test my patience.
Sir Goro!
Are you insane?
Oh, I apologize.
Is that so?
Sir?
Disappointing. You should be ashamed of yourself.
I'm sorry.
I'm really sorry.
I hope you don't mind.
Duh.
Well...
I'm watching you.
Sir! Thank you so much!
That was close.
Yeah, you're right!
Hero.
I don't know.
Anyway.
Yep.
Anyway. Bye. Really? Huh? Maybe.
Hey there.
Hero! Are you all right?
Well,
huh?
No, I'm not. Don't worry. Well,
I see.
Don't worry. Anyway,
of course. Well,
man, this power outage is a real bummer. The rain outside is only making it more humid.
What happened with you? Why are you so sweaty and out of breath?
Remember that I promised Sir Aiden I'd help him with kitchen work?
You woke up so early just to help him out?
I didn't expect it to be so tiresome. We had to use firewood instead of the electric stove. I've been in front of the brick oven for way too long. And dang, it was really hot! And I can't turn on the fans or air conditioning to cool down.
Did he really have to strip in front of me? As much as I want to listen to what Hero is saying, I really can't concentrate. I can see his sweat slowly dripping all over him. I never thought that seeing him this way would be so sexy.
What am I thinking? He's my best friend!
Okay, calm down, Keitaro. Don't be awkward.
Hey! Keitaro, are you even listening? Are you okay? Your face is all red.
Let's take a bath. I mean, you should take a bath. Well, why did I say that? That's going to make this situation more awkward.
Is that why you're staring at my body all this time?
I'm not.
You think I'm sexy? I didn't know you were this naughty. I have to admit, I could use a perverted Keitaro around here.
Hero, what are you saying? I'm not perverted.
Why don't you come with me for that bath, Keitaro? I'd love a chance to grope that cute butt of yours.
Hero, what are you saying?
I'm just messing with you, Keitaro.
still a bit too hot for a bath right now, so I'll just put some clothes on.
It's all right. I understand.
Thanks.
Aw. Actually... Oh no. Calm down. Anyway. Let's see.
Oh no.
I have a theory.
I don't want any of that.
According to my calculations,
huh? Hello. Oh, dare.
Edward.
Hello.
Get out of my sight.
Ew. You!
Well...
Yuck!
Oh.
What are you talking about?
I...
Oh my God.
Huh?
Seriously.
I have a theory.
That is so not fabulous.
That's terrible.
That is true. I don't want any of that.
Actually,
hello.
I know you're hiding something.
Wait, wait! It's not what you think!
You're lying. Seriously?
I don't have time for this. No one is better than Taiga!
Really?
Oh, how lovely.
That is so not fabulous. Really?
Imbeciles. Morons! Victory for Taiga.
Aw, that's too bad.
You don't have any sense of fashion at all.
Taiga is the best!
Anyway, are you amazed at my beautiful face? I'm so fabulous! Yeah!
I... I'm smarter than you.
Totally.
What the actual fuck? Huh?
That wasn't me!
Liar?
No.
But...
I didn't do it!
I don't want any of that.
Shut up!
Oh no. I'll do my best.
Fuck you.
But
shut up. What a bunch of dweebs.
Why, you little...
Get out of my sight!
How dare you!
Well, oh,
Keitaro!
Hiro!
Well,
I'm hungry. See you later.
Wow. Oh. Scoutmaster Yoshi.
Keitaro. As a matter of fact.
Well,
I appreciate it. Whoa! Whoa!
I'm sorry.
I'm glad to hear that. However, Keitaro, the camp president, Mr. Goro, is just concerned about the bad reputation that the camp already has.
Bad reputation? Did something happen before Scoutmaster Yoshi?
I'm glad you're taking interest in the history of our camp, Keitaro. But it is not the most flattering story in my case. Well, I guess it's about time I should tell you about it. I wasn't entirely lucky during my first few years as a scoutmaster. More so, I should say that I wasn't able to do my best in terms of handling my subordinates. An unfortunate event took place last year in this camp. It wasn't my best performance as a scoutmaster. I'm talking about destruction of property, vandalism, and violence.
That sounds very serious. How did it end up like that? Especially in a place like this?
Well, let's just say that the campers last year had a hard time getting along with each other. They're always fighting, making trouble, and they heeded no authority. I wanted to try to make them all get along with each other. So, I've organized a huge team-building activity for them. I thought a friendly competition would get them to interact with one another nicely. Turns out, it was the opposite of what I expected. The winning team refused to share their prize to each member, while the losing team did not exhibit any sportsmanship. They ended up seriously hurting each other.
That's terrible.
It didn't stop there. It had gotten worse with each passing day. Everyone just started hating and blaming each other. No one took the activity seriously, and instead spent their time on delinquency. I only have myself to blame. I'm the leader. I should have been more responsible. Even with all those years of my experience, I was not able to execute my tasks properly.
But everything's all right now, isn't it? I've heard from Scoutmaster Yuri.
I'm sorry, Keitaro, but it's not. The effects of last year's incident were so big that negative rumors about the camp have spread all throughout the city. I ruined the good name of Camp Buddy. Most of the campers were either injured or bullied, forcing them to be sent back home. All of the staff and other scoutmasters resigned too because of that fiasco. You must be wondering why I'm not fired yet. It's all thanks to Yuri. She's a very close friend of mine. She was kind enough to ask her dad to give me this one last chance to run the camp. Sir Goro agreed on the condition that Yuri would accompany me to complete the program for the last batch this summer. After that, Camp Buddy will be closed for good.
Closed? Is there anything we can do to stop it?
Well, there is something.
What is it, sir?
If only I could prove to him that I can do better as a scoutmaster, maybe Sir Goro would reconsider closing the camp.
We can do that. Just tell us what we have to do.
But it's very irresponsible of me to burden you and everyone with this matter. This duty is mine alone to carry.
Don't say that, Scoutmaster Yoshi. Everyone needs to do their part, too. After all, we're a family here, right? I will do my best and get everyone to work as a team.
Oh, Keitaro, I wish it was really that easy. Scouts today are just not as interested as they used to anymore.
Don't worry, sir. We'll think of something. I'm sure of it.
You're one optimistic boy, Keitaro. This camp could really use a person like you. Even with just a week of your stay here, you have made a lot of progress with the people around you. Your unwavering determination to create special bonds is what this place needs. You remind me a lot of how I used to be.
Scoutmaster Yoshi.
But I really am on a stump lately. I don't know what I should do. I'm feeling anxious about Sir Goro staying here to observe my progress. One small mistake for me could be the end of this camp. I need to do something to make him think that this camp is really worth continuing. I'm really embarrassed to ask you this, but do you have any ideas, Keitaro?
How about we take advantage of the fact that Sir Goro is here? Maybe you can still make use of the obstacle course you prepared for us. Let's have a team-building activity again. A friendly competition! I'm sure if Sir Goro sees us working together, he might reconsider about closing the camp, right?
You mean, do what I did back then? Isn't that kind of risky? And what if the other campers don't participate?
You told me the main reason why that incident happened was because everyone had no teamwork or sportsmanship at all. Do you see that kind of relationship among us too?
Well, no, I don't. But it's not just about that. I don't know if I'm able to do my part so far.
I know I haven't been here long enough to say this, but thanks to Camp Buddy. I enjoyed unforgettable moments and experiences with my friends. I owe it to the activities that you and Scoutmaster Yuri gave us. We've definitely gotten closer to each other. I'm sure everyone feels the same.
Really?
We're very lucky to have a Scoutmaster like you, sir. Please don't ever doubt yourself because you're the person we look up to here. Your actions as a leader will reflect on how your followers will act. If you're sad, everyone will feel the same. A buddy always shows a bright smile on his face.
That's the buddy law number 3.
You're right, Keitaro. I cannot just sulk here and hope everything to go well. All of you are counting on me to have a great and memorable summer in this camp. I will give my best, no matter what happens from now on. Yuri was right about you. You really are something.
Keitaro? Scoutmaster Yoshi?
Hunter!
Bye!
I'm impressed!
Yuri. Everyone's counting on me. I know what you're thinking.
You need to try harder. I'm so proud of you.
I appreciate it.
Keitaro!
How about we...
Hey!
Keitaro?
What?
Hey there.
Phew.
Attention. Listen.
Scoutmaster Yoshi?
Isn't this exciting?
What do you mean?
Right.
Hey!
Are you sure?
Huh?
I know what to do. I appreciate it.
Keitaro?
You can count on me. Get moving.
Wait a minute. I'm confused.
Actually,
What's going on?
Thank you.
Hiro!
I don't know.
Keitaro?
Well,
actually, let's see.
Stupid.
I don't know. I don't think so.
For real?
Hiro. As I was saying, however, What's going on?
Actually,
catch you later.
But
It's all right.
I don't think so.
Oh no.
That sucks.
But cheer up!
Keitaro.
I don't know how to say this. I'll do my best!
That's right. Actually, but
wow.
Maybe.
So well, what do you think about this?
Well, I know.
For real?
Don't worry.
We should go now.
Wow!